Hi, I'm Aiko, and this is Amaya. As you can see, me and my sister Amaya are Siamese sisters. We were born attached from the waist down, but we are not the same. When we were born, our parents freaked out completely when they saw us for the first time.
Why won't these babies come apart?
The doctors glued our babies together. I'm gonna sue them.
Mom and Dad lost their senses after they found out we couldn't be taken apart, and they left us at the hospital and ran away, literally. So, we grew up in an orphanage, but it wasn't the best place for Siamese girls to be in. The beds we slept in and the clothes we wore were too uncomfortable, and everyone looked at us like we were some magical creatures.
Hey, can I touch you?
Sure, if you want to lose your arm, go ahead.
Amaya?
Well, yeah, one of the reasons we never had friends was because Amaya would chase all of them away with her bad temper. And I would have to convince her to do things with me to get along with the rest of the kids.
Hey, look, everyone! The magic girls are doing their magic tricks again!
We would do small little tricks to attract donations and people into our orphanage on the weekends, and all the kids would love it. But in spite of all the efforts we put in, no one would pick us for adoption.
Why do you think no one wants to adopt us, Aiko?
Well, maybe it's because they just want one girl and it's the two of us?
No, it's because you're freaks. Face it, losers.
Maria was the bully at the orphanage and messed with us whenever she got a chance.
Well, no one wants you either, Maria.
How does that make you any different from us? She jumped onto me and started pulling my hair off when Amaya planted a punch right into her face.
Take this, Maria.
And then we broke out into a catfight. But to our horror, we went crashing into a vase that was 1,000 years old, and our manager, Mr. Saichi, cherished it more than his life.
Girls!
He looked raging mad and punished us by asking us to clean the entire orphanage and do all the work for a week. And lunch was assigned to Maria. During lunchtime, while she was pouring food into our plates, I saw a wicked smile on her face. And later, as we started to eat, I saw a big cockroach in Amaya's soup. I grabbed the bowl and threw it right into her face.
Are you out of your mind? Why'd you do that?
What else am I supposed to feed you freaks?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want it alive?
Everyone else burst out laughing at her silly joke, but Amaya didn't take it too well. She picked up the cockroach and jumped onto Maria, insisting that she eat it.
Come on, open your mouth now. Let's see you getting a taste of what you serve.
I tried to pull her away, but it was already too late. The manager was already there.
That's enough. I want you both in my office right now.
I was horrified. We were so doomed now. But to my surprise, the manager didn't scold us. Instead, he introduced us to a very handsome man named Mr. Lee.
Oh, girls. You're just 15, but you're so amazing. I have seen you guys perform your little tricks. You're so talented. Would you like to come with me?
I looked at Amaya and hugged her. This was awesome news. But then the manager said he couldn't take us with him.
Why not?
I'm sorry, Mr. Lee, but you'll need a partner to adopt the girls. You can't do that alone.
So this time, Mr. Lee came back with a bearded woman. After the adoption papers were signed, Mr. Lee took us to a freaking awesome place, the circus. We thought we were there for a show, but then he asked us to go backstage. This was weird. The bearded woman asked us to put on circus gowns, then handed us some juggling balls and stuff. And with that, Mr. Lee pushed us onto the stage.
Go, girls, do your magic.
Magic? This was crazy. Everyone was looking at us like we were some zoo animals. And we couldn't even juggle the balls properly. And in no time, people were laughing at us like we were some clowns. But you know what they say, if life gives you lemons, make lemonade. This wasn't half as bad as cleaning the orphanage, and we even got to travel the world for our shows. But soon after, we realized we weren't really happy. It was so exhausting and not a place to call home.
I don't want to live here anymore, like this. Let's just leave.
But I knew Mr. Lee wouldn't let us leave so easily. So we made a plan to run away at night. But just as we were sneaking out, we saw Mr. Lee talking to some man.
These are the animals we stole from the zoo. And there are more on the way. You better hurry up with the payments.
You will get your payment. But we need more unique kids, too. Like the Siamese sisters. Kidnap them if you have to, but I need to expand my business.
OMG! He was such a cruel man! How did we not see this before? We should definitely run out of here. He's so dangerous. No, Amaya, we can't. Think of all the other people he's gonna trap, and these innocent animals? We have to do something about it. We immediately went back to our tent and called the police. Within the next few hours, there were cops swarming in like bees and arresting anyone involved in the illegal buying and selling of animals, including Mr. Lee. After the chaos was over, a police officer came to us and told us we were going to receive a huge amount of reward money for giving them such a big lead. Yippee! This was super awesome! There were also news reporters and TV channel reporters to interview us for our bravery, and all of a sudden, we were like celebrities. After receiving the huge reward money, we shared some of it with the other circus workers too. And from our share, I insisted on buying a small house for both of us, and Amaya saved the rest for her secret plans. Then one day, we were eating out at a restaurant when I bumped into a table and almost fell to the ground when a guy caught us. He was our age and had such gorgeous eyes. I almost fell in love with him at first sight when Amaya interrupted. Are you blind? Can't you see? Amaya, it's not even his fault. I bumped into the table. I hushed her and the guy even asked me out later. This was crazy. I went home and tried all the best dresses, but Amaya didn't seem to be a sport. During the dinner date, he held my hand and we were having romantic talks when Amaya went all bonkers on the waiter. What is this? You call this food? My vomit looks better than this. Take it away. And Amaya, being Amaya, chased the guy away. Later, when we reached home, I was super mad at her. Why'd you do that? Why are you always so angry? Do you even realize how much I have to adjust and sacrifice because of you? I like that guy so much. What? How can you even say that? Do you think you're the only one adjusting here? Well, I'm here too, in case you didn't notice. Of course, I was wrong to say that, but I was angry too, and this was one of the times I hated us being inseparable. Later, when Amaya wouldn't talk to me for hours, I made a plan to cheer her up. What are you doing? Going out. But I don't want to. I want to sleep. But I do want to go out. I pulled her out to see the stars and hugged her real tight. I'm so sorry that I was mean to you, but I swear I'm never going to do it again. You matter most to me in this world, Amaya. I love you. And happy birthday. Suddenly, she had tears in her eyes. I'm sorry too, sis. You have to live with my stupid temper all the time, and you never complain about it, but you don't have to anymore. What? What do you mean? Amaya told me she wanted to consult a doctor and get us separated so we could live our lives like normal people. This was crazy. She even said we could use all the reward money for our separation operation. But that would mean we won't be together, like this. Yeah, I know, but we will always have each other, right? We deserve to be happy and live our lives, Aiko, and fall in love like you want. I was speechless. This was the best birthday gift ever. The next morning, we went to see the best doctor in the city for our operation.
All right, blood tests are fine, girls. I think a few more tests and we can proceed.
Wow, really? But we don't have any risks, do we?
The risk is very low. You don't share organs, that's fortunate. There are other Siamese patients who are not so lucky.
We were so happy. After meeting the doctor, we went back home and there was a middle-aged woman who came running up to us and hugged us.
Aiko, Amaya, my daughters, I missed you so much.
What the freaking heck? She was our mom? You're our mom? How did you find us?
Oh, I'll do better. Why did you leave us in the first place?
What do you want now? We had so many questions, but she just burst into tears.
Oh, my babies. I'm so sorry. I left you both alone, but your dad and I were so poor back then, and we freaked out. Please, please forgive us.
Forgive my butt? I don't believe you. You can't be our mom. We look nothing like you, and if you're insisting so much, then why don't we get a DNA test right now? I was fired up with anger, but she was indeed our mom. She even had our birth certificates with her. Then she told us some shocking news.
Your dad is super ill and he wants to see you both. Please, I beg you both to come and see him for the last time.
It didn't feel right, but she was literally holding onto our pants and wouldn't let them go. And that's when Amaya said, "We should give her a chance." I was super shocked, but then I could understand her emotions, so I let her meet them once. When we reached their place, we saw a man lying in bed all sick, and all of a sudden, he turned into a drama queen.
"My daughters, oh my daughters, I'm a criminal. I was such a bad dad. I deserve to die. I did so wrong to the both of you. Please forgive me."
He hugged Amaya and she went all emotional. We sat and talked by his side for a while, and then Mom told us how they needed money to get Dad treated. Of course, I wasn't liking any of it, but Amaya seemed to connect with them so soon. Later when we got back home, she told me she was gonna use the money for Dad and not our operation. But why? They left us when we were just babies and now they wanna use our money? So what? They're our parents and they're miserable right now. We should help them. No, Amaya, this is what we've always wanted, to live normal lives. You can't give it away just like that. But more than that, I've always wanted a family, Mom and Dad. And we've lived like this all our lives. We can live the rest of it too. Please, Aiko, please. I didn't know what to say after that. She was so happy after meeting Mom and Dad, and I didn't want to take away her happiness. So I decided I was gonna support her decision. We went back to tell Mom and Dad, but what we saw shocked us to our bones. They were partying and eating tons of dinner kept on the table.
"These stupid kids have no idea we're gonna take that reward money and run with it. I could tell they grew up into such fools when I saw them on the TV. Good that we left them."
Yeah, they were so dumb. But do you think they'll give us the money? This was it. Amaya had tears in her eyes and I couldn't take it anymore. We went in and I threw the garbage bag I picked up from outside straight onto them. "That's what you deserve, and that's what kind of people you are. Garbage."
"Yeah, I trusted you guys, and I thought you were genuinely sorry. But I was wrong. You guys are the most horrible people I've ever met. And I've met a lot."
Saying that, we stormed out of their place, and we realized the only family we had was each other. And it was enough. A few days later, we even discovered that our parents were serving time in jail for not being able to pay their debts. Well deserved. Of course, after that, we got our operation and we were successfully separated without any complications. And now, we're free to live life as we want.